So what is the dealio with 10 Cloverfield Lane? I know it stars my favorite actor John Goodman and cute babe Mary Elizabeth Winstead, and I know it was made by Dan Trachtenberg and J.J.J. Brams, but what's really going on here? The film starts with the title Cloverfield on screen, and then 10 and Lane gradually fade in. This, coupled with the fact that it was originally billed as the Cloverfield sequel that Ray J made in secret, could lead you to a certain conclusion. Obviously, the trailer made it look like its connection to the first film wouldn't be readily apparent, so I spent my time watching this flick waiting for the big reveal. And evidently, this was a mistake. Now look, I'm not an angry person, especially since my doctor made me start taking these.
If they gave me Tic Tacs again, I'm gonna have a very big problem with my HMO.
But it really annoys me that according to people that I've talked about it with, apparently I'm a huge fucking idiot for thinking this movie would be a sequel. J. John Jonbrum said in an interview, "This movie is very purposefully not called Cloverfield 2, because it's not Cloverfield 2. But while it's not what you might expect from a movie that has the name Cloverfield in it, I think you'll find that you'll understand the connection when you see the whole thing." Well, guess what, you curly-haired dork? I don't understand. And that makes me feel stupid. And I don't like when people make me feel stupid because secretly I am stupid and I don't want anybody to know. Does anybody remember this guy? Am I the only one? Doesn't whatever was going on here seem kind of important? The phrase I see thrown around a lot is spiritual sequel. I'm sorry, but there is just a serious lapse in logic here that I'm just totally missing. If this is a spiritual sequel, then what is the spirit? What is the through line that these films have in common? They're both science fiction films, but as far as I can tell, the similarities end there. Is Mac and Me a sequel to Alien? They're both sci-fi. Is Heartbeeps a sequel to Metropolis? Is Space Chimps a sequel to 2001? Three examples is good enough, let's move on.
I've been told to judge this movie on the merits of what it is, as opposed to what I want it to be.
But the movie starts with Cloverfield as the title before 10 and Lane fade in, for crying out loud. I feel like this movie is trying to intentionally mislead me. The movie itself is engaging, and it holds your interest with good pacing and a lot of suspense. But for a movie that's supposed to be twisty, personally I thought it was kind of lame because I saw every twist coming. Want me to ruin every movie ever for you? Because I can do it. Whatever the film is trying to lead you to believe, the opposite of that is going to happen. The film tries to make you think John Goodman is crazy for thinking aliens are invading, so naturally the twist is going to be that he was right. The only twist was that it was aliens specifically, because since I'm apparently a huge fucking idiot, my expectation was that the danger trapping these characters underground would be Clover. It would have been that simple for them to have connected this film to the first. Instead, we get aliens that we don't care about. Now, apparently, this movie started its life as a spec script called The Cellar by Josh Campbell and Max Stueck, but then Jimmy J. Grahamcracker made edits to make it more similar to Cloverfield. But because none of those similarities are evident, I don't know what he did. Here's what really happened. Jimmy J. went to the studio and said,
"Hey guys, I got a great new movie where John Goodman hangs out in a basement with a hot babe."
And the guys at the studio said,
"Sorry, James, original IPs don't perform well anymore. People are only interested in sequels and reboots these days."
And then Jay thought, That's right, Jar Jar Arbrarms, you curly-haired fuck. I smell what you stepped in and tracked inside. Oh, and another thing? You look like Barton Fink! And you thought nobody would notice. Well, guess what, Hollywood? I notice everything. You can't pull the wool over my eyes. Now you might be thinking, "Max, you big sexy moron, I know all of this, it's obvious. Hollywood pulls deceptive marketing bullshit to get our butts in the seats all the time." But the fact that more people aren't annoyed just goes to show how accommodated everyone's grown to all of their bullshittery. So knock it off, Juju Ubrams. But you know what? I still love ya, cause Lost was good. I'm Max G, this was my brain dump of the week, and I hope you hated it. Fall down the stairs, you miserable dipshit, oink!